is ready for her mount, Natalia Leshchenova.
She begins with a front flip mount, right into a walkover. Really a dynamic little gymnast, has been wowing the coaches during practice. She's very new to international competition, and this is where it will help as she gets prepared for October. Back handspring layout, look how high she was, even though she had a bobble there. Almost 2.5 feet off that beam.
She is 13 years old. First trip to the United States.
The Soviets work with such beautiful ballet movements. They may fall, but their body, they don't give away points in form breaks. And they're normally very aggressive on this apparatus. Back walkover, getting prepared now for back layout. Beautiful toe point there. 13 years old.
4'6".
You can see, she shouldn't wait too long for a dismount, but the full in, double back from two back handsprings. Great exercise, lots of difficulty there.
A little hop on the end that'll cost her a tenth or so.
She really could rival Shishinova and Omelianchuk in the future. She is so young. Let's take another look at her dismount. Two back handsprings here. She's right on. Everything's straight. Full twist on the first back flip and then does another one. Another flip at the end. Watch this again. Sometimes in normal speed it's difficult to see, but here she's way over the top of that beam, finishes her full twist on the first flip, and really pops out the second part of the second flip.
Natalia Leshchenova. Now she will wait. Hopefully the judges will be able to generate these numbers a little quicker than they did the other numbers. And there it is. 9.80 is the score. As we now pick up with the floor exercise of 13-year-old Natalia Leshchenova.
And she had a very spectacular opening. If you remember Mary Lou's opening at the World at the Olympics, it was a double layout. Well, she just did it extremely well. A whip over, poop up, full in, double back. You can't get much more difficult than that. What a pixie on this event. So tiny, 13 years old. Full twisting back handspring. She just has to finish this last tumbling run. Looks like her lips are almost blue. There she goes, back handspring, full in, double back for an ending. The most difficult routine in the competition.
Very nice, and the crowd here at the Denver Coliseum enjoying it very much.
Natalia Leshchenova ligger på femte plats för mankampfinalen. Och Bogenskaja fick 9.95 för sitt andra hopp som blir hennes tällande karaktär. Därmed har Bogenskaja skaffat sig ett gott utgångspunkt i kampen om medaljerna. Katsev över upp av Leshchenova. Stalder bakover på Nedre Holme. Kjempeslenger. Og dobbelt pikert salto ned. Litt uheldig.
なかなかいいんですね。
ソビエト、ラチノワの平均台です。ソビエト、この前にバイトワが平均台を置いていますが、そのバイトワは 9.90。シェフチェンコは 9.80。ここまでソビエト、平均台は 9.80 と 9.90。平均台も好調なスタートを切っています、ソビエト。これ高いですね。
高いですね。
素晴らしいですね。
しかも両足立ちですね。
あ、そうですね。
はい。
ラチノワ、15歳の新鋭です。今の後方宙返りは見事でした。なお、ルーマニアのポパの床は 9.80 と出ました。この時点でちょっとまたスベートとルーマニアの差が若干ですが開いています。
ジャンプ安定してますね。
ちょっと惜しいこの辺り。 非常に器用な選手なんだそうです。このラチノは今上り調子の選手。これもいいですね。
スピードがありますね。
すごいスピードですね、
はい、やはり両足踏み切りの後転跳びというのはスピードが出やすいですね。やはりハッとしますね。もういい得点が出ますね、はい、きっと
今得点が出ました。 9.875 と出ております。ラチノワの平均台です。ソビエトのラチノワがこの床のまずトップバッター。
噂ですとこの選手は第1シリーズに3回宙返りを持っているらしいんですけれどもね。
そうですか。
今回は団体の自由でも見せてもらえませんでしたね。
3回宙返りですか。
そうですね、男子がこの間自由で1人見せてくれましたけれども、
ここちょっとやってもらいたいですがね。
そうですね、まあ使わないですね。
ここは伸身のダブルできました、はい、何気なく伸身のダブルで来たんですが、これも難しい技なんですよね。
そうですね、まあ、3回宙返りがダメでも伸身のダブルがあるということで、もう技は豊富に持ってますね、
はい、自分の持ち技を格下げしても伸身のダブルで来るということですから、相当レベルの高い選手です。
そうですね、高すぎて後ろに飛んでるという感じですね。
勢いが余ってね、はい、
選手は140センチという身長らしいですけれども、とてもそんなに低いとは思えませんね、はい、
そうですね、
はい、演技自体がとても大きいですね。
140センチ、35キロ。このラチノワは2種目目終わって第5位につけております。月面できました、ピタッと決まった。いい演技でした、ラチノワ。
もう難度はもう十分ですね、
はい、
まあ、ただもうそれの選手にしては少し着地ですとかそういう後始末が雑な気がしますね。
そうですか、
はい、
この床はソウルオリンピックのために新しい構成に変えたということなんですが、
伸身のダブルのところですけれども、
初めですね、一番。
そうですね、まあ、わずかに膝が開いて緩んでいるので、
ええ、
3回宙返りできる選手でしたらもうぴったりとくっつけてほしいですね、
まあ、特にソビエトの選手は姿勢の美しさが定評ですからね。
ここでもですね、これだけ足の開きがありますので、はい、これを閉じてやって、しかも着地まで止めれるようにしてほしいですね。そうするとやはりもう少し 1,2 分上がりますので、もっと順位も上に行くと思います、ええ。
さあ今ラチノワの得点が出ました。 9.90 です。 9.90 高得点となりますと、この後のシュノワシリバスがどれぐらい出すか。
そうですね、これでもう着地まできちんとやっていけば当然10点は期待できますね。
はい、
eyes now are on the wonder girl of the competition from the Soviet Union, Natalia Lashinova, the all-round champion. Can she also take this vault?
Now let's look for a first-rate performance. This girl is world championship material on this apparatus. Oh, excellent, but just that one step on landing. She'll be a little disappointed with that.
Now that very same vault earned her 9.950 during the all-round competition. Let's look for the mistake here on landing. Just that one step back, how unfortunate. And now for a second vault, the all-round champion of this Grand Prix, Lashinova of the Soviet Union.
Oh, now that's a job. She knew she needed a better landing on this second vault.
Both scores here are counting, of course, Peter, and not from the previous competition, so both of these need to be good.
And this was more than good. Let's have a look at it. 1.5 front somersault with half twist. And that's absolutely perfect.
More than good indeed. 9.925. That'll be very hard to beat. Here's the dominator of the competition. She's just won the vaulting competition. Now up on the uneven bars, Natalia Lashinova.
Now Lashinova, known for her peerless technique on this event. Look for the strong handstands. First release, very clean catch-up vault. Second release, Ginga, no problem there. One release required, but at this standard in finals, two releases gives the girls that little bit extra bonus from the judges. Very clean so far. Oh! No other word for it, magnificent routine. We saw the same performance on vault, and here again we see supremacy from the young Soviet.
That's got to go close to a 10, Peter.
I would think so, Don. And in replay, beautifully high Kachev, straight into a second release. Now the combination of two highly difficult movements gives some extra bonus to the girls' routine. There's one touch on the low bar. The girl's required to have two bar changes during the routine. In other words, they can't just work on the horizontal bar.
Well, surprisingly, just a 9.8 there, but she's going to be hard to beat. Now, once again, we have Natalia Lashinova from the Soviet Union to compete, and she's made all four finals this evening. And of course, remembering only the top two competitors from each country are allowed into the final.
A very difficult front somersault onto the beam. Easy enough on the floor exercise, but onto a 10 centimeter wide beam, very hard to land. Lashinova, like all the Soviets, very precise in her movements, very elegant. Tumbling pass. Oh, beautiful stuff. Layout somersault. Heaps of room for the landing. Now, those sort of movements are her trademark. Very powerful young lady. That's unique. Leap series. Very controlled at this stage, very precise. Oh, there's a small wobble. Layout step out, very sure indeed. Now, on the beam, the girls have to show different level changes, work close to the beam and work high above the beam as we see now. Included in her movements must be rhythm changes. And she's demonstrated that beautifully tonight. Dismount, back handspring, oh, pull in, oh yes! What a dismount, full twisting double somersault. She did not demonstrate that dismount the other night. Most unexpected. And of course, a pleasing performance by Lashinova of the Soviet Union.
That's the extra difficulty you were talking about before, that she's tried to put in the end of her routine.
Yes, Don. Beautifully done, just one step on landing.
And that 9.75 gives her the lead. Next competitor from the Soviet Union, Natalia Lashinova, And she has the score of 9.8 to beat from Australia's Kylie Shadbolt.
It's great to see the Australian setting the standard here, but of course we're now looking at one of the world's best gymnasts. Watch for the interpretation of this music. Using music, Hall of the Mountain King. First tumbling pass, double layout. Oh, no problems. The crowd's totally involved at this stage. This is a beautiful routine, characterizing everything that we've come to expect from a premier floor routine. Now the excitement builds, we have second tumbling pass. Oh, great job, double salto, excellent landing. Now can she finish just as strongly as she started? The next few seconds will tell. Full twisting double, good landing. Oh, brilliant floor routine, amongst the world's best.
It's not hard to see why she was our all-round champion here.
She'll be pleased with that. In replay, the second tumbling pass, look for the shore landing right here.
Gee, just a 9.8, that's the same score as Kylie Shadbolt.
Svetlana. But this is Natalia Leshenova of the Soviet Union in the vault, currently tied for sixth place with Brandi Johnson after two rotations.
What makes this vault so terrific is watch how she thrusts her arms to the side when she's completed it, just to show off how easy it is for her to do.
And Natalia says, anything you can do, Svetlana, I can do just as well. Different apparatus, but same results. A perfect 10.
For the moment on everything, this is Leshenova coming off a 10 on the vault a moment ago. Natalia Leshenova of the Soviet Union. Score on Henrik's second vault, 9.75, does improve slightly from the first.
Oh, beautiful high reverse half. Oh, look at that, way up above the bars. This is what you're looking for in bars. Scalder work as well. Again, a good combination of skills. Many of the girls have what we call stock routines, all the same, and this isn't. Very different from the others and done exceptionally well.
You're looking at gymnastics that, I have to say, from my limited experience, is as good as it gets.
It's pretty darn close.
Leshenova, remember, had a 10 in the vault.
この状態にはさほどは影響してませんけれども、必ずしもいいとは言い切れないところですよ。さあ、この人もソビエトの、エースのうちの一人と申し上げます。ナタリア・ラシェノワ。
ソウルオリンピックは個人総合5位でした。ここが見せ場なんですね。片足で着台をする選手が多い中で思い切って両足で踏み切って両足着台する。ほとんど頭の位置が肩の位置に来るぐらい宙返りが浮いてるんですよ。
非常にこうソビエト選手の中ではパワフルな感じですね。
そうですね、はい、それだけに足腰にはもう定評がありますから、折り技ももしかしたらムーンサルトを見せてくれるかもしれませんよ。もう一つ伸身の宙返りですね。さあ、ここまでのところほとんどミスありません。ここからがフィニッシュです。
さあどうでしょうか。月面宙返り、
はい、素晴らしいですね。
Still plenty more to come from the World Championships here in Stuttgart, and we'll have more right after this. Meanwhile, floor exercise, Leshenova, who at the risk of being redundant has also had a brilliant evening here with a 10 in the vault, a 995 on bars, and a 9962 on beam.
But this is detail. Watch her facial expression. Layout, back handspring, straddle jump, punch front. Tumbles back the other way, through to a double back. That's more difficulty in her first pass than most people have in their entire routine. If I were her, I'd stop right there.
And just take your 10, go home, right?
This really is amazing. But what's so nice, on top of all the difficulty, the toe point, the execution, the perfect form. Whip back through to a double back. She's now done the equivalent of two routines. We'll see what she has in store for the last tumbling run. A double back and another perfect landing. Now this is where you'll see a 10.
Gab es für Andrea Drissler am Stufenbahren und nun, von ihr war schon die Rede, Natalia Laschenova aus Riga in der Sowjetunion, Vize-Weltmeisterin im Mehrkampf hinter Svetlana Boginska ja im vergangenen Jahr hier in Stuttgart. Doppelsalto, saubere Übung. So ganz zufrieden scheinen sie nicht. ein bisschen Haltungsfehler geöffnet.
Lovely smile. She waves goodbye to the World Student Games with her final performance. Lashanova now of the Soviet Union. 19 years old. Went to Seoul in 88 for the Olympics. Well, that was higher, that was cleaner, that was straighter.
A little scuffle at the end. But I don't think I'll predict the score this time.
Well, he's certain, Mitch, we're seeing some exceptional vaulting here, aren't we?
Absolutely brilliant. I mean, look at this. It's early doors, remember. There's still a gymnast to follow this. Absolutely beautiful. High, clean, very high. Spectacular.
Oh, the score coming through, and it's a very, very big one.